Hello, Indiana. Oh, no, 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 no. Stop, stop, stop. That was half-assed. All right, when I say hello, Indiana, you guys are going to greet us. Ready? Hello, Indiana. That was better. Now you guys are awake. Wake up the people in the back. All right. So we're here. How are you? You guys having fun? Yeah? All right. Do you know what you're in here for? Is anyone confused? Oh, kind of. All right. Well, you're in here. We're going to be reading a movie script. Do you know what movie? We're reading Star Wars, and we're going to have a whole lot of fun. What I want to tell you off the bat, if I see any little ones in here, if you have any little kids in here, this is PG-13 to rated R. Leave now. No complaining later if you choose to stay. Nobody got up. That's good. All right. Usually all the freaks and perverts yell and scream at that part. There she is. All right. All right, we're going to get rolling. Now, when we bring them up, we're going to have to practice this every time. You got to get louder every time, all right? All right. First up, let's bring out, how about Maurice LaMarche, guys? He's coming. Keep screaming.
Anywhere you want, buddy.
Where do you want me?
Sit anywhere you want.
All right, I'll sit down again.
Next up, we have to have somebody beautiful on the panel, so we're going to bring up Gray Delisle Griffin.
Anywhere you want. You want to sit? You want to sit here?
I thought they were talking about Richard Horvitz. I was like, oh, wait, let Richard go.
We don't want to frighten the children. All right, we'll bring him up anyway, though. How about Richard Horvitz, guys? Keep clapping. He's older. He walks slow. Keep clapping.
Yes. Hello! Love you too.
All right, guys. This is active participation. So when the scenes come up where we need audience, we need you guys loud. So get ready. That you're involved. You're part of this. All right. Oh, the pens are here. Perfect. All right. Now that we have pens. All right. Let's start. Okay. Let's see. Scene one. We're going to have the narrator, Maurice. How about William Shatner?
Yes.
See, we already made people happy. I like that. All right, we got both of you here. We're gonna have C-3PO as Mandy, and R2-D2 as Billy. Billy and Mandy, come on, Grim Adventures. People in the back, wake up! All right. There's a lot of one-liners. So Maurice is the captain. How about Morbo, Futurama? Let's see, I got Shatner. Is Darth Vader Gray? We need Vicky.
Okay.
All right, in the back, you're losing it. These are my favorite people right there. They're the only people yelling so far. Come on. All right, as Princess Leia. Hey, Mo, how about Foghorn Leghorn? As the stormtrooper, it's one line, Rich. I just want you to do whatever you want to do. You like that? Yeah. All right. And then last but not least, there's two lines for Jawas who don't really say anything. And Maurice does these really cool, he's very talented. He does these weird things with his voice, so he's going to just do that for you and entertain you. So remember, when he does it, it's the Jawas.
These are Jawas that ate too much corned beef. For lunch. That's all I'll say.
Oh, he's in here. It's the first page.
Ready?
Where are you?
As we will ever be.
Hold on a second. Hold on.
No, we are not.
Hold on a second.
Hold on a second.
Hold on just one second.
That is.
Jeff Zannini has more roles to assign.
Okay, I see.
Hang on a second. Let Gray catch up.
I found him. He's right there. Victory!
Yes, but where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
I'm gonna guess San Diego.
Oh, there she is.
Oh, there she is. Waldo, Carmen, Carmen, Waldo. You could have the perfect relationship. You'll never see each other.
It's like a Hollywood marriage.
All right, whenever you guys are ready.
It is a period of civil war. Rebel spaceships striking from a hidden base have won their first victory against the evil Galactic Empire. During the battle, rebel spies have managed to steal secret plans to the Empire's ultimate weapon, the Death Star. An armored space station with enough power to destroy an entire planet. It's pursued by the Empire's sinister agents. Princess Leia? Leia? I don't say Leia. You say Leia. I say Leia. Even she doesn't know what the hell her name is. She changes pronunciation and accents 3 times. Races home aboard a starship, custodian of these stolen plans that can save her people and restore freedom to the galaxy.
All right. Where are those transmissions you intercepted?
We intercepted no transmissions. This is a consular ship. We're on a diplomatic mission.
Commander, tear this ship apart until you found those plans and bring me the twerps. I want them alive.
Lord Vader, we have a prisoner.
This is Princess Leia, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Darth Vader, only you could be, I say, only you could be so bold. The Imperial Senate will not sit still for this. When they hear that you've attacked a diplomatic...
Don't act so surprised, Your Highness. You weren't on any mercy mission this time. Several transmissions were beamed to this ship by rebel twerps. I want to know what happened to the plans they sent you.
Why, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm a member of the Imperial Senate on a diplomatic mission to Alderaan.
You're part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor. Take him away. Whatever it is.
Meanwhile, on the desert planet below.
How did we get into this mess? I really don't know how. We seem to be made to suffer. It's our lot in life as idiots.
Destroy us all!
Shut up. I've got to rest before I fall apart. My joints are almost frozen. Oh, what a desolate place this is. What mission? What are you talking about, Billy? I've had just about enough of you, C3 Billy. Go that way. You'll be malfunctioning within a day, you nearsighted scrap pile idiot. And don't let me catch you following me begging for help because you won't get it. No more adventures. I'm not going that way.
Exterior sand dunes.
Oh, God. The malfunctioning little twerp. Oh, this is all his fault. He tricked me into going this way, but he'll do no better. Wait, what's that? A transport? I'm saved. Over here. Hey! Hey, help! Please help! I don't often say please, but help!
Meanwhile, in a canyon not far away.
Yeah.
scene.
I like you.
That was fucking great. That was great. Front row is a splash zone. You didn't know that, did you? All right. All right, people in the back, man, seriously, we need to hear you on this next one.
People in the
back! I can see you. All right, next up. Let's see here. C-3PO, Maurice, how about Inspector Gadget? That went over well. All right. As the Jawas, Rich, how about Woody Allen? As Luke Skywalker, Gray, Azula.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
As Uncle Owen, Rich, Invader Zim. As Baru, Gray, whatever you want. Just like Rich, have fun.
Okay.
And as the narrator, it's only one line, but you have no idea how good of an impression Rich does of Katharine Hepburn. So we're going to have Katharine Hepburn narrate one line.
Oh, yes, here we go.
Whenever you're ready.
Yes. Exterior Sangrala. Inside the Sangrala, the Jawas prepare for a sale.
I know, because I'm already surprised.
All right.
Yes.
We've stopped. R2-D2, wake up. Wake up.
Jeez. Wub, wub. Wob. I teach a class on masturbation. If I'm late, they start without me. Jeez.
We're doomed. Do you think they'll melt us down?
Untini. Yeah.
Don't shoot. Don't shoot. Will this never end?
Am I Owen?
Yeah.
Uncle Owen's Invader.
Oh, it's Uncle Owen. Oh, yes. Hey. Hey. All right. Fine. Let's go.
I'm going to be Anita Baker for Beru.
Yes.
Luke. Tell your uncle if he gets a translator, be sure it speaks Bocce.
Greetings, peasants. Doesn't look like we have much of a choice, but I'll remind him.
Hey, yeah. Well, we'll take the red one. No, not that one! You! I suppose you're programmed for etiquette and protocol.
Protocol? Why, it's my primary function, sir. That and go, go, gadget copter. But I am well-versed in all the customs of...
Zim has no need for protocol, droid!
Of course you haven't, sir. Not in an environment such as this, which is why I've also been programmed.
Hey, programmed? What I really need is a droid who understands the binary language of moisture. Vaporators, take me to the weasels!
Vaporators, sir, my first job was programming binary load lifters, which is very similar to your vaporators in most respects.
Hey, can you speak Bocce?
Not only can I speak it, I play it very well. It's like a second language to me. Why, I'm as fluent in Bocce as I am in...
All right, shut up!
Shutting up, sir.
I'll take this one. Luke, take these two over to the garage, will you? I want them cleaned up before dinner.
Dinner. Luke, are you there?
Oh, I'm Luke.
Yes.
Yes, fool!
Oh, my goodness.
You filthy stink beast, it's your line!
Shut up before I burn you alive.
Yes.
But I was going into Tosh, is it Tosh? Station to pick up some power converters.
Yeah. You can waste
can waste time with your friends when your chores are done, fool? Now come on! Get to it. Get to it!
All right, come on. And the red one, Fire Nation colors. Come on. Well, come on, Red. Let's go. You should have feared me more. Uncle Owen, this R2 unit has a bad motivator. Look.
Hey, look at this! Wait! What are you trying to push on us, fool?
Excuse me, sir, but that R2 unit is in prime condition. A real bargain.
Uncle Owen, what about that one?
Hey, yes. What about the blue one? We'll take that one. Hey.
Yeah, take this away.
I'm quite sure you'll be very pleased with that one, sir. He really is in first-class condition. I've worked with him before. Oh, here he comes.
Okay, let's go.
R2, don't you forget this. Why I should stick my neck out for you is quite beyond my capacity.
And scene. All right, that was much better in the back.
You are the perfect replacement for Don Adams.
Don Adams is irreplaceable, let me just say that. Aww. I worked alongside him in the original Inspector Gadget, and he has the best comic timing of any actor I've ever worked with. But thank you for the compliment.
I'm sitting right here.
As I said, the best comic timing.
Gray is sitting
the
right here.
The second best comic timing of any actor. The third best comic timing of any actor I've ever worked with.
Missed it by that much.
Thank you.
See, that's why you come to this, just for that. You never know where it's going to go.
Neither do we.
Sometimes it's south. Okay.
By the way, does everyone know what all those sounds were in the movie? What all the Rich was making?
Beep, boop, beep, beep, boop.
No, little nobody. Droid, do any of you know the movie? It was when the R2 unit exploded. That was Rich's. All right, we'll just have him do better next time.
All right. How about this?
All right.
Excuse me.
We'll move on. The next scene.
I exploded in my pants.
Oh my God. Not in a good way.
Good night, everybody. All right.
Is there a good way?
Oh,
here
yes,
and now?
Is.
I don't think so.
We told you PG-13 to rated R. All right. And the next one. Rich, you did such a good job. Catherine Hepburn, it's one line. Just do it again. Carmen Sandiego loved it, so we're going to do it one more time. All right. As Princess Leia, Maurice, Yosemite Sam. As Luke, Gray, Daphne from Scooby-Doo, my favorite. As C-3PO, Maurice, the Brain. And as R2-D2, I mean, how can we not put Rich there? How about Alpha 5? Yes. Alpha 5 it is. All right, whenever you're, it's a big stretch, you're a robot, so go ahead.
All right, here we go. It's the Lars homestead. Later that night, oh dear, it's another Spencer story. You know, Spencer used to make in the laurel sheets all the time. Later that night, in the homestead's garage.
Keep it going, I'm taking a drink of water.
Garage!
Thank you.
Thank the maker. This oil bath is going to feel so good. I've got such a bad case of dust contamination, I can barely move.
Well, jeepers, it just isn't fair. Oh, Biggs is right. I'm never gonna get out of here.
Is there anything I might do to help?
Well, not unless you can alter time, speed up the harvest, or teleport me off this rock, but leave my outfit the same.
I don't think so, sir. I'm only a droid and not very knowledgeable about such things. Not on this planet, anyway. But back home, I try to take over the world. However, on Tatooine, there's not much to take over. So I'll resume my role as C-3PO in this minor amusement. As a matter of fact, I'm not even sure which planet I'm on.
Well, I'm not the smartest one in the gang, but if there's a bright center of the universe, you're on the planet that it's the farthest from, I think.
I see, sir.
You can call me Luke.
I see, sir, Luke.
No, just Luke, thanks.
Oh, and I am C-3PO, human-cyborg relations, and this is my counterpart, R2 Pinky.
Well, jeepers, hi there.
Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay! Narf!
Well, you got a lot of carbon scoring here. Looks like you boys have solved a lot of mysteries.
I carbon scored myself.
With all that we've been through, sometimes I'm amazed we're in as good condition as we are, what with the rebellion and all.
You know of the rebellion against the Empire? Oh, so that, creepy.
That's how we came to be in your service, if you take my meaning, sir.
Quit calling me sir, please. Have you been in any battles?
Several, I believe. Actually, there's not much to tell. I'm not much more than an interpreter, and not very good at telling stories. Well, not at making them interesting, anyway.
Well, my little friend, you remind me of Scooby. You got something jammed in here real good. Oh, it's in your butt. Were you on a Star Cruiser, or what's this?
Ay, 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 ay! There's trouble in Angel Grove!
What's this?
What is what? He asked you a question. Stop doing that annoying voice and tell her, what is that?
Narf!
Beep, 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 beep. Ay, 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 ay! Zordon! There's some putties!
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You're my only hope! Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You're my only hope! Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You're my only hope!
Oh, he says it's nothing, sir, merely a malfunction. Old data, pay it no mind.
Ooh, who's that? I want a mustache ride. It's red. Our hair's the same color.
Narf.
Narf indeed, Pinky. Narf. Yes. I'm afraid I'm not quite sure, sir. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You're my only hope! I believe she was a passenger on our last voyage, a person of some importance, sir. I believe our captain was attached to.
Is there a money shot in this recording?
Ay, 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 ay! Ay, 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 ay! Ay, 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 ay! Yay!
Behave yourself, R2. You're going to get us into trouble. It's all right. You can trust him. He's our new master.
Ay, 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 ay!
Even if he is wearing a purple dress.
Ay, 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 ay!
Well, he says he's the property of an Obi-Wan Kenobi, a resident of these parts, and it's a private message for him. Quite frankly, sir, I don't know what the hell he's talking about. Our last master was Captain Antilles, but with what we've been through, this little R2 unit has become a bit eccentric, shall we say.
Obi-Wan Kenobi? I wonder if he means that creepy old Ben Kenobi.
Aye, 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 aye!
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You're my only hope!
And help scene. Me.
That wasn't even in the script. I just really love doing that. I improv that. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You're, sorry.
You'll never see that scene the same again.
Yeah.
And how many of you guys out there finally had Daphne come to life in that one, huh?
Hey, where are we going from here?
Always the way I thought it.
Where are we going?
All right.
Where are we going from here, 10?
Well, guess what, guys? We have some special guests coming up here. We have some crime-fighting turtles in the back that want to join the crew. How about we bring up Cam Clarke, Townsend Coleman, and Barry Gordon. Wow, how lucky are we, guys?
What?
What are you guys doing?
I feel lucky. We're just hanging out. The people in the back aren't really awake, though. They're not clapping as loud as the front. I don't know what's going on.
Did they pay as much?
Wow.
No. So if they don't clap in the back, we're going to have you guys just stop.
Okay, let me hear the folks from about 10 rows to the end. Let me hear you.
Not bad.
There you go. So they're kind of sleeping.
One more time. Hit it big.
That was better. That was much better. All right.
Everybody knows the back's way more exciting anyway.
What?
Ay, 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 ay. Zordon, there's trouble in Daphne's Grove.
Oh, kiss and tell, Gray.
Daphne has come full circle for me. I don't know about the rest of you.
Full circle is right.
Just like last night, right?
Ooh.
So anyway.
I like circles.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi, you're my only hope.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Spencer needs help.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope. I want to go home.
Eddie M.
I'm stuck on this planet.
Who rang that bell?
We're out of control. All right, bring it back in.
Okay.
What are we doing?
We're going to read Star Wars, and you're going to start on page 10.
10.
Top of 10.
There you go. Page 10.
Okay.
All right. So since you're here, what else are we going to do? But how about Luke as Michelangelo?
All right.
All right.
R2-D2 is Donatello.
Okay.
And C-3PO is Leonardo. All right, so we'll start there. Now let's fill in some pieces here. How about Uncle Owen? Hey, Rich, how about Chaos from Skylanders? Yes. She knows that one. Mm-hmm. It's going to be narrated by Edith Bunker.
Okay.
Yeah. Princess Leia, we have to bring back one more time. Yosemite Sam.
Oh, my God.
Who would bring him back? I promise after this that'll be it, but then by then it'll be in everyone's head and they'll never forget it after this scene.
All right.
And then Baru has one line, Gray.
Okay.
Whatever you want to do.
Okay.
Just no more Daphne stuff. I can't stay on the stage if you keep doing that. It's killing me. All right. Whenever you're ready.
Well, gee, I don't know anyone named Obi-Wan. But old Ben lives out beyond the Dune Sea. He's kind of a strange old hermit.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my... Huh.
Well, I wonder who she is. Sounds like she's in trouble. I better play back the whole thing here.
Beep. Weep. Wow.
He says the restraining bolt has short-circuited his recording system.
Oh, is that what I was saying?
Yeah. He suggests that if you remove the bolt, he might be able to play back the entire recording.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Well, I guess you're too small to run away on me if I take this off.
Come here. You're my only hope.
Okie dokie. There you go.
Help me, Obi-Wan.
Hey, wait a minute. Where'd she go? Well, bring her back. Play back the entire message, dude.
Warp.
Sorry.
Well, what message? The one you've just been playing. The one you're carrying inside your rusty innards.
I'm going to do Baru as a crazy, senile old lady.
Luke! Luke!
All right, I'll be right there, Aunt Baru. Gee.
I'm sorry, sir, but he appears to have picked up a slight flutter.
Yeah, well, here, see what you can do with him. I'll be right back.
Just you reconsider playing the message for him. Beep! Wee! No, I don't think he likes you at all.
I don't think you like me at all, Jeff. Whirr! Whirr, whirr! Beep, whirr!
No.
Wee!
I don't like you either.
Whoa! Wee! Woo!
R2-D2's like lost a little of his pizzazz.
Meanwhile, in the Law's dining room, narrator, the Law's family settles in for dinner, ah!
You know, I think that R2 unit we bought might have been stolen.
What makes you think that, says Chaos?
Okay, well, I stumbled across the recording while he was cleaning him, and he says he belongs to someone called Obi-Wan Kenobi. I thought he might have met old Ben. Do you know what he's talking about?
Woo-wee!
That portal master is just a crazy old man. Tomorrow I want you to take that Doom Shark R2 unit into Anchorhead and have its memory. And have its memory.
Wiped.
Wiped. And I said memory, and that's all you will be wiping. That'll be the end of it. It belongs to us now.
Yeah, but what if this Obi-Wan comes looking for him?
He won't, fool! I don't think he exists anymore. He died about the same time as your father, Eon.
Whoa! Hold the phone. He knew my father?
I told you to forget it, fool! Your only concern is to prepare the new droids for tomorrow. In the morning, I want them on the South Ridge working on those condensers.
Meanwhile, at the Law's homestead garage. Oh. Later in the garage.
Oh, oh. Oh, sorry.
Jeez. Oh.
Oh. What are you doing?
Oh, 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 oh.
Excuse me, what are you doing hiding back there?
It wasn't my fault, sir. Please don't deactivate me. I told him not to go, but he's faulty, malfunctioning. We have to think of something fast.
Hey. We've got to do something.
He kept babbling on about his mission.
Oh, no.
For the Mormon Church in Argentina.
What? Oh, yeah. Oh,
meanwhile,
yeah.
In Argentina.
Ese Arto Unido ha sido completo un problema. Los asteroids van a ser mucho afuera de mano. No puedo entender la lógica a veces.
Huh?
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
Oh, dudes, how could I have been so stupid? He's nowhere in sight. Blast it. Blast it.
Pardon me, sir, but couldn't we go after him? We are heroes in the half shell.
No, dude, it's too dangerous with all the sand people around. We'll have to wait until morning.
Shutting the power down.
All right. I'll be there in just a few minutes. Boy, am I gonna get it. You know that little droid is gonna cause me a lot of trouble down there in the sewer.
Well, he excels at that, Michelangelo.
Okay, come on, dude.
And scene.
Come on, let's hear it for the turtles. We're going to keep them up here for one more scene. They do some other characters, too, so we're going to go. We're going to keep moving. Where are we at? Oh, we're doing good on time.
Are we keeping you up?
See, look, the people in the
in
back
a good
are
way.
Out cold, man. Out cold.
Am I going to get, like, words this time?
Sure.
Oh, no. Barry,
all right, we'll give
words.
You words. How about, well, let's let the audience decide.
Oh.
We've got two choices.
All right.
This isn't put your hand up and ask me. No, no. He can do the Nestle Quick Bunny or Bebop. If you want Bebop, scream. If you want
the
Nestle
bunny, so the bunny then.
Quick Bunny, scream. Wow, the back is awake.
I guess it's the Quick Bunny.
Woo!
All right, Nestle Quick Bunny it is. All right, so as Bebop, you're going to be C-3PO.
Okay.
As R2-D2, Mo, how about Dizzy Devil?
That's really easy on my voice.
Yeah.
Thanks, Jeff.
You're welcome. As Obi-Wan Kenobi, we got Metal Gear Solid fans out there? Yeah! How about Liquid Snake? Yeah! All right, Liquid Snake, you are Obi-Wan Kenobi. As the narrator, Gray Sam Manson from Danny Phantom.
All right, that's cool. That's cool. I'll do that.
And Rich, we have a Tusken Raider who obviously is going to be fun, so how about you go crazy with that?
All right.
And as Luke, anyone ever seen The Tick?
Yeah, The Tick.
All right, Townsend, The Tick is Luke.
All right, baby.
Okay, dudes, so...
Whenever you're ready.
Luke and C-3PO go ghost across the desert in Luke's land speeder.
Look at here, evildoer. There's a droid on the scanner, dead ahead. It might be our little R2 unit. Hit that accelerator.
They catch up to R2-D2 in the bottom of a canyon.
Whoa. Just where do you think you're going?
Yummy. Master Luke is your rightful owner now. We'll have no more of this Obi-Wan Kenobi gibberish. And don't talk to me of your mission either. You're fortunate he doesn't blast you into a million pieces right here.
No, it's all right, but I think we'd better go.
The pizza rolls!
Oh, no. Gross. What's wrong with him now?
Oh, there are several creatures even uglier than me approaching from the southeast.
Sand people? Or even worse. Come on, Arthur. Let's go have a look. Come on. Well, there are two banthas down there, but I don't see any... Whoop! Yeah, wait just a second. If I look there, oh, there's sand people, all right. I can see one of them right now.
Yeah.
Spoot!
Spooty.
A Tusken Raider clubs Luke. The sand people take the opportunity to begin raiding the land speeder, but flee when they hear the roar of a deadly crate dragon.
Yeah. Hello there. Come here, my little friend. They're gone for now. Oh, don't worry. He'll be right back. Rest easy, dear brother. You've had a busy day. You're fortunate to be all in one piece. Unlike me, I'm just an elbow. Sorry, never mind.
Ben? Ben Kenobi? Spoon! Boy, am I glad to see you.
Yes. Will you and your little spoon? Oh, the Junlan wastes are not to be traveled lightly. Tell me, dear brother, what brings you out this far?
Well, it's this little droid here. You know, I think he's searching for his former master, but I have never seen such devotion in a droid before. He claims to be the property of, let me check here. It seems right. Obi-Wan Kenobi. Is he a relative of yours or something? Do you happen to know who he's talking about?
Obi-Wan Kenobi. Could he also be known as Solid Snake? Now that's a name I've not heard for a long time. A very long time.
Yes. I think my uncle knows him. I'll have to call him. He said he was dead.
He's not dead. Or not yet.
Wait just a minute. You know him?
Well, of course I know him. He's me. I haven't gone by that name of Obi-Wan since before you were born.
Oh, well, then this droid does belong to you.
I don't seem to remember even owning a droid. Very interesting. I think we better get indoors. The sand people are easily startled, but they will soon be back and in greater numbers.
Oh, no. 3PO!
Where am I? I must have taken a bad step.
Over there, 3PO, can you stand? We've got to get out of here before the sand people return.
I don't think I can make it. You go on, Master Luke. There's no sense in you risking yourself on my account. I'm done.
Oh, no, you're not.
I am. I'm
what not. Kind of talk is that, little guy?
Little guy.
Quickly. They're on the move.
End scene.
End scene.
Folks, can we have a huge round of applause for these three guys coming up?
Thank
here?
You.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
And a huge round of applause for these guys.
Yes. Woo, woo, woo.
Thanks for coming out, you guys.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, guys. All right, let's see. Next scene. We have, it's only four parts. We have Luke. We're bringing Billy back because he has words now to say for you guys.
Bringing sexy back.
Yes.
Yeah, I bring sexy back.
As Princess Leia, it's only one line and it's a good amount, but it's got to be Chris Rock's mom because okay. Gray, if you haven't heard it yet, you know who Chris Rock is. Imagine his mom. Yeah. Gray's okay. Going to do that for you.
Okay.
And as Obi-Wan, all right, we have a choice for Maurice. He can either be Kif or Calculon from Futurama. So if you shut up. If you want Kif, scream. If you want Calculon, scream. Calculon takes
Calculon,
it.
Calculon, Calculon.
All right. Oh, the narrator has one line.
You do it.
No, you guys do it. Want to do it,
it
together? It's one line. It's the narrator.
Do
it's
the together?
Opening line.
At the very top there?
Whenever you're ready.
Okay. Okay. Just all together?
Yes.
Sure.
All right. Come on, Cam. Join the crowd here.
Luke and the droids travel back with Obi-Wan to his home.
That's what your uncle told you.
What?
He didn't hold with your father's ideals.
What?
He thought you should have stayed here.
What?
And not gotten involved.
Ooh! You fought in the Clown Wars?
No, I fought in the Clone Wars.
Oh, good, the clowns will destroy us all!
Excuse me, but you're interfering with my unholy acting talent!
Yes! Woo!
Yes, I was once a Jedi Knight, the same as your father.
Jedi Knight?
I wish I'd known him.
He was the best pilot in the galaxy and a cunning warrior.
What?
I said he was the best star pilot in the galaxy and a cunning warrior.
Oh, okay, now I heard you.
I understand you've become quite a good pilot yourself.
Well.
And he was a good friend.
Oh.
Which reminds me, I have something here for you.
Ooh, what is it? Is it pie? I like pie.
No, it's not pie.
You.
Your father wanted you to have this when you were old enough, but your uncle wouldn't allow it.
I hate my uncle.
I'm not fond of him either. He feared you might follow old Obi-Wan on some damned fool idealistic crusade.
I like old men.
And I like you. This is your father's lightsaber.
Wow, a lightsaber!
It's the weapon of a Jedi Knight, not as clumsy or random as a blaster, an elegant weapon for a more civilized day. For over 1,000 generations, the Jedi Knights were the guardians of peace and justice in the Old Republic, before the dark times, before the cancellation of Futurama.
Ooh, yeah! Yeah, that was pretty dark.
Before the Fire
Nation
attacked.
Third one.
Say, I have a question that I've always wondered. How did my daddy die?
A young Jedi named Darth Vader, who was a pupil of mine until he turned to evil, helped the Empire hunt down and destroy the Jedi Knights. Yes, he betrayed and murdered his father. Yeah, well, I don't see the humor in that. Now the Jedi are all but extinct. Vader was seduced by the dark side of the Force.
Yeah, seduced, huh?
In the back.
By the Force in the back?
They don't call it Force for nothing.
The Force is what gives a Jedi his power in the back.
I want to be a Jedi then!
Well, wait, you may want to hear this. It's
okay.
An energy field created by all living things, you see. It surrounds us and penetrates. Here, read this pamphlet.
I have a force in the back. Want to hear it again?
Here, the pamphlet says it surrounds us and penetrates us. It binds the galaxy together. Binds. Keyword there.
Penetrates.
Binds. Binds, penetrates. You get the idea, little boy. Now, let's see if we can figure out what you are, my little friend, and where you come from.
Well, I saw part of the message. He was...
I seem to have found it.
Oh, good.
Oh, look, a blank page. Oh, another blank page.
There's lots of blank pages.
Christ help me.
I'll just sing while you find it.
It's my turn.
Oh.
General Kenobi. Years ago, you served my father in the Clone Wars. Now he begs you to help him win his struggle against the Empire. I regret that I'm unable to present my father's request to you in person, but my ship has fallen under attack, and I'm afraid my mission to bring you to Alderaan has failed. I placed information vital to the survival of the rebellion into the memory systems of this R2 unit. My father will now know how to retrieve it. You must see this droid safely delivered to him on Alderaan. This is our most desperate hour. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
You must learn the ways of the Force if you're to come with me to... Dramatic pause. Alderaan.
Alderaan. I'm not going to Alderaan. I've got to go home. It's late. I'm in for it as it is.
I need your help, Luke. She, dramatic pause, needs your help. I'm getting too old for this sort of thing.
Say, you sound like Captain Kirk. I can't get involved. I got to go work to do. I said do. It's not that I like the Empire. I hate it. But there's something I can do about it right now.
Use a do again.
I just did that. It's all such a long way from here.
That's your uncle talking.
Well, oh boy, my uncle. How am I ever going to explain this?
Learn about the Force, Luke.
What? Look, I can take you as far as Anchorhead. Have you ever been to Anchorhead?
No.
It looks just like a Prince Albert.
Yeah, you're going to love it. You're going to love it. It's great. You're going to love it. Look, I can take you as far as Anchorhead. You can get a transport there to Moe's Island, or wherever you're going, something like that.
You must do what you feel is right. Dramatic pause. Of course.
And scene. Yeah. All right, we got another special guest for you guys. We're gonna share seats. We have Cora in the building. Janet Varney's here. She's coming. Keep clapping.
Janet Varney.
There's too many seats now. Thank you all. I'm gonna need those three too, if you don't mind. Who doesn't need to sit or wants to sit on my lap?
What's
happening?
No, take my chair.
Thank you. Cora and Azula together. Let's see who survives.
Over.
Here we go.
Grab a chair.
Oh my. Oh my, my, my.
Say, what's your name? Have you ever been to Anchorhead?
I'll show you my Anchorhead up in the hotel room if you'd like.
Oh, sorry, I like pie.
Help me, Obi-Wan, Kenobi. You're my only hope.
Being in voiceover is so boring.
And that's why the warning is out there before we start.
There we go.
All right. So we're going to share, or are you going to slide
the chair?
We got a chair here.
Whatever you want to.
That's so bittersweet.
No.
So
we got a chair.
You can sit in my lap.
You can.
Just a second.
Very close.
All right.
Yeah, Richard.
Yeah, we're going to all.
God, we got plenty of rooms.
We'll make it work.
That's all the time we have. Thank you.
All right. So, all right, this is really improv. I wasn't ready for this. All right.
Where am I?
Let's just go right down the list here and just have fun. Townsend, Fraggle Rock fans out there? All right, Gobo, is it going to be Tag? Commander Tag.
Tag?
Yes, okay. That is Gobo. Let's see, holy shit, I wasn't ready for this. Modi, it's going to be Kif, for all you people that wanted Kif, Mo, Modi. As Obi-Wan Kenobi, since she's here, how about Cora?
Yeah.
As the Stormtrooper, Gray. Dorothy or Glinda?
Okay, I'll be Dorothy.
Dorothy it is, from The Wizard of Oz. Narrated. Kim, how about Ricardo Montalban? Don't you do a little Spanish there for us?
Si lo puedo hacer, si quieres.
It'll be narrated in Spanish by Kim.
Or Freddy the Ferret?
All right.
Freddy? All right.
Freddy the Ferret, or you want... Oh, wait, what about... All right, Freddy the Ferret, or you want him to just do crazy stuff in Spanish? Crazy stuff in Spanish, scream.
For what?
Freddy the Ferret, scream.
Oh, this is...
I don't even know what I think the crazy Spanish
about.
One, that one.
Where are you?
We're on page 18.
That's ABC.
All right, so Cam is going to narrate in whatever language he chooses. He can make it up. We won't know the difference. All right, as Luke, who do we have? Has everyone got a part so far?
Not me.
Oh, we want to do, oh, Rich, yeah. I already got yours. Invader Zim is coming back as Darth Vader.
Ah! Okay. All
right. As Luke, Barry, do you want to do the Nesquik Bunny? Because there's a lot of lines. I know you don't want to do that when there's a lot of lines.
Yeah, I'll do it.
All sure. Right, well, we'll do it. So you're going to get the Nesquik Bunny. And then as Tarkin, has everyone got a part?
I think so.
Everyone has a part? All right, we need to put someone in as Tarkin.
Do Freddy for Tarkin.
Well, there you go. Everybody wins. Freddy the Ferret right. Is going to be Tarkin. I don't know who that is.
Tarkin?
I can't wait to hear it.
Freddy the Ferret?
Yeah, Tarkin.
Okay. Gotcha. Gotcha.
All right.
Don't look at me like that. He's looking at me that way.
How do you want me to look at you?
The anchorhead says.
The anchorhead. All right. Whenever you guys are ready.
In cima del Death Star, military commandantes have gathered.
Oh, boy. You know, I think, Wembley, you rock dust allergies all in your head. We gotta go exploring in outer space. And until this battle station is fully operational, we're vulnerable. The Rebel Alliance is too well equipped. They're more dangerous than you realize.
Dangerous to your Starfleet, Commander, not to this battle station.
The Rebellion will continue to gain a support in the Imperial Senate just as long as... The Imperial Senate will no longer be of any concern to us. I've just received word that the Emperor has dissolved the court permanently. The last remnants of the old Republic have been swept away. But that's impossible. How will the Emperor maintain control without the bureaucracy?
The regional governors now have direct control over their territories. Fear will be keeping the local systems in line. Fear of this battle station.
Uh-huh. And what of the Rebellion? If the Rebels have obtained a complete technical readout of the station, it is possible, however unlikely, that they might find some doozer sticks and eat them. And the weakness they'll find, they'll exploit.
The plans you refer to will soon be back in our hands.
Any attack made by the rebels against this station would be a useless gesture, no matter what technical data they've obtained. This station is now the ultimate power in the universe. I suggest we use it.
Don't be too proud, fool. Of this technological terror you've constructed, Dib Monster. The ability to destroy a planet is insignificant next to the power of the Force.
Ugh. Don't try to frighten us with your sorcerer's ways, Lord Vader. Your sad devotion to that ancient religion has not helped you conjure up the stolen data tapes or given you clairvoyance enough to find the rebels' hidden fort.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
You say Tarkin, and I say Tarkin.
Enough of this! Vader, release him!
As you wish.
Oh, my.
This bickering is pointless. Now Lord Vader will provide us with the location of the rebel forces, next line, by the time this station is operational. We will then crush the rebellion with one swift stroke. Stroke. Echoey.
Who's narrating?
Who's the
Oh, that's me. On Twintine, Luke and Obi-Wan Kenobi are searching through the wreckage and debris of an attack on Jawa's sand crawler.
Well, it looks like sand people did this all right. Look, there's gaffy sticks, bantha tracks, and it's just, I never heard of them hitting anything this big before.
They didn't, but we're meant to think they did. These tracks are side by side. Sand people always ride single file to hide their numbers.
These are the same Jawas that sold us R2 and 3PO and this other stuff that's so chocolatey.
Luke, please, focus. Naga, you too. And these blast points, too accurate for sand people. Only Imperial stormtroopers are so precise.
But why would Imperial troops want to slaughter Jawas? If they trace the robots here, they may have learned who they sold them to. And that would lead them back home.
Wait.
Quick! See? Back home. Quick! Quick!
Luke!
Back home!
We don't have time for product placement right now. It's too dangerous.
Uncle Owen! Aunt Beru! No!
Boy.
Not so fast! Oh. You can't drink it slow if it's quick!
I swear to God, I'm gonna bend your little chocolatey milk ass right back into... Keep it together, Cora. There's nothing you could have done, Luke, had you been here. You'd have been killed too, and the droids would be in the hands of the Empire.
Well, I want to come with you to Alderaan.
Please
There's
don't.
There's nothing here for me now. You drank all the damn chocolate milk. I wanna learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
It's Jar Jar Quick.
Me so thirsty.
That explains a lot.
I can't believe I'm about to say this. But come with me to Mos Eisley. Ugh.
If you insist.
That was a land speeder.
I know.
A landspeeder viene al outskirts of El Pueblo. Storm et troopers are conducting searches de los vehículos.
Mos Eisley Spaceport, you will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Oh, well, how long have you had the Tin Man and this other droid?
About 3 or 4 seasons.
Yeah. They're up for sale, if you want them.
Well, I don't know. Let me see your identification.
You don't need to see his identification.
We don't need to see his identification.
Look into my white avatar eyes. These are not the droids you're looking for.
Oh, these are not the droids we're looking for.
He can go about his business.
You can go about your business, going back to Kansas.
Move along.
Move along. Move and ride along.
Okay, different movie, but.
And
but I'm
scene.
A fan. Big fan.
Move and ride along.
All right, guys, are you having fun or what? All right, step it up louder. This is the last scene. All right, so let's bring who do we got left here? As Luke, you love Daggett. How about we give him more lines?
Yeah.
All right, at least, yeah, you like that. All right, so Ridge, Daggett is Luke. As Obi-Wan Kenobi, want to stick with Wizard of Oz and do Glinda?
Okay.
Glinda the Good Witch will be Obi-Wan Kenobi. Dr. Evesian, Mo, how about Peter Falk?
All right.
Those of you that aren't laughing, Princess Bride, the narrator, Princess Bride, his name's Peter Falk, all right. Now we hear someone in the back. All right. As Greedo, one of my favorites, we're going to have Janet do her impression of Arnold Schwarzenegger.
You'll think he's in the room.
We have, let's see, as the bartender, Barry, which ghost were you in Pac-Man?
Inky.
Inky from Pac-Man is going to be the bartender.
Bartender, all right.
It'll be fun.
Okay.
Let's see. We need, we got a one-liner for C-3PO. Who wants it?
I'll do it.
What do you want to do? Anything? All right.
Does it pay?
No. Townsend is going to be C-3PO.
Tom Brokaw.
Tom Brokaw, sure. That works. Tom Brokaw. We have an alien for a line. Cam, who would you like to be?
Tim Gunn.
Tim Gunn it is. And because we have to hear it one more time, we need Vicky as Han Solo. And she's going to be talking to herself, so I want you to really pay attention to this part. It's really funny. And there's a lot of sound effects, so as you hear and they see it, they'll all just jump in on
Don't
the sound.
Don't it's going to be really funny before it's not really funny.
One line. C-3PO.
What page is
it? It starts on page 21, Cam.
Okay.
There you go. All right. Whenever you guys are ready.
Okay, music,
folks.
And
everybody.
We could be here a while.
We don't serve their kind here.
What?
Your droids. They'll have to wait outside. We don't want them here.
Listen, 3PO, why don't you wait out by the speeder? We don't want any trouble.
I heartily agree with you, sir.
I'll be back. I'm going to speak to that Wookiee over there.
Nag, Oda, De Waga.
Thank you.
Captain Clarke, ladies and gentlemen.
Make it work, people.
He doesn't like you.
Spoot, I'm sorry.
I don't like you either. You just watch yourself. We're wanted men. I have the death sentence in 12 systems.
I'll be careful.
You'll be dead.
Oh, it's not worth the effort. Come, let me tell you, get you something.
Pew, 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 pew.
No blasters!
Ow, Jesus Christ, that hurt. And I'm right-handed, too. What? Whoa, I'll be fine, though. I'll just pick up my arm and leave it. That was incredibly rude, if you don't mind my saying. But I'm going to go, as you wish.
Hi, I'm Han Solo, captain of the Millennium Falcon. Chewie here tells me you're looking for a passage to Alderaan system. Yes, indeed, if it's a fast ship. Well, fast ship? You haven't heard of the Millennium Falcon? Hello?
Should I have?
It's the ship that made the Kessel Run in less than 12 parsecs. I've outrun Imperial starships, not the local bolt cruisers, mind you. I'm talking about the big Corellian ships now. She's fast enough for you, old man. What's the cargo?
Only passengers. Myself, the boy, two droids, and no questions asked.
What is it? Some kind of local trouble?
Let's just say we'd like to avoid any Imperial entanglements.
Well, what that's the trick, isn't it? And it's going to cost you something extra. 10,000 in advance and a milkshake.
10,000? Ooh, we could almost buy our own ship for that.
But who's gonna fly it, kid? You?
You bet I could. I'm not such a bad pilot myself. We don't have to sit here and listen to this bullshit.
We haven't that much... language. We haven't that much with us. But we could pay you 2,000 now, plus 15 when we reach Alderaan.
17, huh? Okay. You guys got yourself a ship. We'll leave as soon as you're ready. Docking Bay 94.
Oh, 94. Well, that will be, we'll be there soon. Come, Luke. There's no place like Docking Bay 94. There's no place like Docking Bay 94.
Looks like somebody beginning to take an interest in your handiwork. Chewie, get back to the ship and get her ready.
Una guta solo?
Yeah, Greedo. As a matter of fact, I was just gonna see your boss. Tell Jabba that I got his money.
It's too late. You should have paid him when you had the chance. Jabba's put a price on your head so large that every bounty hunter in the galaxy would be looking for you. I'm lucky I found you first.
Are you hard of hearing, Greedo? Anyway, yeah, but this time I got the money.
If you give it to me, I might forget I found you.
I don't have it with me. Tell Jabba!
Jabba's through with you!
Oh, my.
He has no time for smugglers who drop their shipments at the first sign of an Imperial cruiser, and it's not a tumor! I see you looking at me.
Don't grab my butt. Okay. Even I get bored sometimes. Do you think I have... I'm not your nanny. What do you think? You said that.
Talk to me some more about getting bored.
Over my dead body or unconscious body. Do you know Bill Cosby?
Bill Cosby couldn't be here today.
That pudding pop tasted awful.
All right, listen, you tell that to Jabba. He may only take your ship. That's the idea. I've been looking forward to killing you for a long time.
Yes, I bet you have.
Oh, you shot me first. Oh!
Pew, pew, pew.
Before I could even raise my pistol and shoot at you, now I'm dead. But I'll be back.
Have some cappuccino.
Folks, big round of applause for these folks. Come on, let's hear it. Thank you very much. They'll all be signing autographs out there in a few minutes. Come say hi.